I do tend to subscribe to the idea of not having or focusing on regrets because everything we've done sort of makes us who we are now. And I'm happy with who I am now, and especially in terms of my academic pathway and my career in physics. But if I was to look back at my undergrad degree in hindsight, there are probably things I would try to do differently. I don't know how they would affect where I do end up. Maybe it would be better, maybe it would be worse, but there are probably things I would try to change. So one of them is probably trying to do more courses in or to do a minor in computer science. So I've spoken about the importance of coding in computer science in terms of physics before, but I do think it is really important and becoming more so. I took some courses in computer science, but not enough for a minor or a major. I instead did my majors in physics and math. It's hard to say with this one because to have done a major or a minor in the computer science as well, like I was already taking more courses than you're supposed to every semester, so I would have had to cut something out, maybe cut the maths out. And I probably could have done without the maths since I'm doing an experimental physics project for my PhD, but I enjoyed the maths all the same. In some ideal situation, I would have had enough room to do the triple major without adding any more time onto my degree, like another year or another semester, because I didn't want to do that. But yeah, I think ideally I would have done some more of those comp sci courses. The second thing I wanted to talk about was kind of my approach to studying at university. And it came down to essentially being a memorization and cramming task for every exam period. At the time, this felt like the best way to get through because we had so many assignments and so many courses that I always found myself sort of disregarding that some of the really deep connections and meanings behind what we were doing and just focused on how do I get the best grade in the exam. And that really became my focus, especially in exam period. And I don't like that, especially in hindsight. I look back and I think I really wish I actually understood that concept more, even though I got a good grade on it. I don't know, like with this, it seems to be almost a systematic thing, sort of across people and across courses, that the uni system is focused more on outcomes and grades than it is on your deeper understanding. So I don't know if this was entirely my fault or just the way kind of things have to be if you want to get through. It's also hard to look back and say I would change that approach because I did get good grades throughout undergrad. And if I'd taken time to really slow down and really learn, I don't know if I would have had time, to do everything that I needed to do. So it's a bit of both, but definitely I look back and I think I probably wish that I asked more questions of my friends, but also of the lecturers, and to really try and understand deeply the content rather than being happy with just getting a good grade on it. I think the most common questions that I asked my friends were just, "Hey, how do you do question three on the assignment?" I think now that I'm a PhD student, I have more time to investigate those deeper learnings, and so that's something I'm trying to do now, because in hindsight, I didn't really get the time to appreciate it as an undergrad. I hope that that helps someone out there, and thanks for watching.